Nick DeLeon, 6th goal for Toronto FC, part of the 5-1 victory over Cincinnati on the weekend. Nick DeLeon, 6 goals, 4 assists on the season. They both match career highs in Major League Soccer. And yet, DeLeon has played over 400 less minutes than he did in his rookie season where he put up those impressive numbers. This is your TFC Insider presented by the all-new Kia Telluride, and I am Gareth Wheeler. A good time to shine some light on Nick DeLeon and how he actually ended up here at Toronto FC. Speaking with head coach Greg Manny, he's tracked DeLeon for years and went beyond his professional career. In fact, Manny started tracking and taking notice of DeLeon as a player when he was a youth growing up in Arizona. Manny actually played under DeLeon's father for the very famous club, the Paradise Valley Shamrocks, when he was growing up at the under 12 level. Manny loved DeLeon's father, Leroy, as a head coach. And DeLeon, as a player, Nick that is, has many of the same attributes, good dribbling, good in attacking areas, and that's why Vanny's had long-standing interest. While playing for DC United, every time they'd call the club, Vanny would ask about DeLeon's availability, only to have that phone call, be cut down rather short. When he did become available through the MLS re-entry draft last winter, Toronto FC and Vanny jumped at the opportunity. Now, Vanny tells me he brought him in really to be a wide player for the team, but it's his versatility that's jumped off the page. Greg Vanny actually likes him a little bit more playing inside, more as a number eight, the fact that he can run hard in those pockets of space. He's so athletic, and he's one of the better finishers on the team as well. He's right now third in team goal scoring, so that versatility and reliability is huge. In fact, DeLeon played right back against Cincinnati, a position where Vanny's very comfortable playing him. Now, DeLeon doesn't really love playing at right back. Nick tells me that when he was forced to play back in a deeper position for DC United, he really didn't like it and really didn't embrace the role. But the fact that Vanny came up to him from day one and said from time to time he might need him at that position, there was a professional relationship and understanding that was formed between player and coach. Now DeLeon actually likes playing the position. He really credits his maturity and the fact that TFC plays in a much more attack-minded brand that's allowed him to thrive at that position. Still, Nick tells me he much prefers to play the number eight role where he can run into those pockets of space. He loves to be aggressive. He tells me that he believes he's a dying breed, a player who likes to get stuck in, get involved in a tackle, something that he sees in young Richie Larea as well, but really it's inside where he sees his future being at this club. DeLeon's importance is particularly showing right now. It's crunch time in Major League Soccer, where those experienced, veteran, domestic players help see your team through difficult times. Doesn't matter who your DPs or your TAM players are, you need players of the profile of DeLeon to succeed. It happened in 2017 with TFC. Moore, Betashur, Morrow, the backbone of that championship-winning team. Even last year in Atlanta, Larenovitz and Parker, so critical to winning. DeLeon fits that mold this season as well. So it's a proper match between player and club and profile, and it's coming up huge for TFC. Look for DeLeon to feature at right back again on Wednesday night in New York as TFC takes on the top team in the Eastern Conference in New York City FC.